Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jellin. This is episode 1535, Consolidate and LOOKUP. All right, well, we are having a lot of fun with VLOOKUP Week. Check it out, vlookupweek.wordpress.com. Check out the ode to VLOOKUP. Just absolutely amazing, the things that people came up with. I'm going to go back here to my days as a data analyst. Here I have hundreds of rows of data, customer number, customer name, and some numeric fields, and I want to collapse it down to one row per customer. And I'm going to use a command back here on the data tab called consolidate. Now, consolidate only works with a single column of labels, but I'm going to show you a cool trick here where we can use VLOOKUP to have it all work. So consolidate, what's the reference? The reference is all of this data. And we're going to use labels in top row and left column. Click OK. Here's what we get. We get one line per customer. There's the customer number. And it's total all of this up perfectly. Customer name, of course, it couldn't get because it doesn't know how to total customer names. So we're going to put a count number there. And to fill in the customer name, equal VLOOKUP. Go look up this account number back in this range. Hundreds of data points here. Press F4, comma, 2, comma, false. But I don't care that there's hundreds. Like, for example, there's maybe 50 records that have 4. Doesn't matter. This is just going to give me the first one, which gets me that customer number. Now we need to copy that and paste his values. And we now have a nice 27-row data set instead of hundreds of rows. You can use this for all types of things. So VLOOKUP in combination with consolidate, great way to consolidate that data down to one record per customer. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel. Hey, just a quick program note. On Thursday of this week, CFO Magazine will be doing a webcast devoted to VLOOKUP and all variations of VLOOKUP. Check that out at cfo.com. Click on webcasts.